Since we have learned the theory behind lay time, have you ever solved any questions or numerical examples on lay time? Do you know what all abbreviations do we use in lay time? In this lecture, we're going to look into these. Hey, what's up guys? My name is Akash from ShipScope, bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. In the Chartering 101 series, we have seen the basics of chartering, we have seen the chartering process, we have seen the legal and other terms used in chartering. We have even seen a proper charter party form and relevant clauses. And in the last lecture, we studied about the concept of lay time. In this lecture, we're going to see some numerical examples and some abbreviations used in lay time. Also, if you're new here, consider subscribing it at any point of the video and check out the notes and links in the description below. If you like the content, guys, you can always go to my website and get the whole thing downloaded. The whole comprehensive pack consists of the comprehensive lecture notes, which we are going to study right now, and the ICS past papers. Some of them I've already solved it, and my own lecture notes. The whole point is to make you understand this concept very well. So let's get into it. Hi guys, welcome to Chartering 101 by ShipScope. So today is lecture number 8 and we will be doing the lay time calculation. In our previous lecture, we studied about the lay time concepts, and in this lecture, we are particularly focused upon how to solve them. All the concepts which we learned in our previous lecture, we'll be applying in this one. We'll be studying about the dry cargo lay time calculation and the related abbreviations to it. Before we get into this calculation, I would like you guys to have a calculator with you, your own phone, and a piece of paper with a pen so that we can solve it together. So the first example, using the following information, prepare a timesheet and calculate whether it's on demurrage or dispatch. Use 4 decimal places for all the calculation. Statement of fact is prepared by the agents. Cargo to be loaded as per the bill of lading is 82,594.37 metric ton. Again, this is a very important figure which you should write it down. Motor vessel Athena is loading at Jakarta. The second important thing which we should see is what are the relevant charter party clauses pertaining to the lay time. It says lay time to commence at 1400 if NOR tendered within office hours before noon. That is first condition. I mean, if the NOR is tendered before 12 o'clock, the lay time will commence at 2 o'clock or upon commencement of loading, whichever occurs first. The keyword is whichever occurs first. So there are two things. What happens if the NOR is tendered after 12 o'clock? So if the lay time to commence at 8 o'clock next working day, if NOR is tendered within the office hours after noon, which is after 12 o'clock, or upon the commencement of loading, whichever occurs the first. Cargo to be loaded at a rate of 30,000 metric ton per weather permitting port working day. Port stevedores. These are the port stevedores when they will be working throughout the day. So from morning 7 to 12, the second shift is from 1 to 6 o'clock and 7 to 11:30 at night. Lay can is 19 to 25th February. If you remember, we did stress upon this lay can. The lay can is 25th. The vessel should reach between these periods. Time from 1800 Friday until 7 o'clock in the morning on Monday, not to count unless used half lay time, UUH. Time shifting for anchorage to berth, not to count as lay time. Demurrage is 17,250 per day pro rata, and DHD is demurrage half dispatch. The dry cargo calculation. Now, again, we are looking at a timesheet here. It starts on Friday, 11th, 11 o'clock, the vessel arrives at mouth of the river and proceeds toward the berth. At 11:50, all fast at berth. That means the vessel is moored. 11:55, master tenders the NOR, so it's before 12 o'clock. At 12:55, cargo surveyor approves vessel for loading. 1 o'clock, the loading commences. Loading stop for today. On that day, at 6 o'clock, it was stopped. Then comes the Saturday, which is 21st. Morning 8 o'clock, the loading is resumed from 10 to 11:20, rain. So there is a delay. And at 1800 hours, loading is stopped. Sunday, 22nd February, 10 o'clock to 23:30, loading on overtime. Double pay except the usual meal breaks. But in that condition, on Sunday itself, there is a shore breakdown from 13:30 to 15:45. Shore crane breakdown. On 21st, on Monday, loading resumes at 7 o'clock. And there is a rain delay on Tuesday between morning 3:30 to morning 8 o'clock. On Wednesday, loading is completed at 5:35. Port agents come on board in order to sign the BL. And finally, the vessel is sailed at 6:50. So this is how it looks like. Now let's start doing this problem. The first thing is just make sure that you have this setup prepared. You need to make sure that you have to write load port, date, day, starting time, ending time, lay time used in days, hours, and minutes, and what are the remarks are. So we'll start solving each and every question. Before that, I'll just make sure that you take a snapshot of these two screens with your phone, which will help you to go back and forth. This is the first one, and this is the second one. Okay, so let's start solving the question. The first thing is, on 20th February, the vessel arrives at 11 o'clock, and it is vessel is proceeding towards the berth. On 20th at 11:50, all fast, no lay time to be consumed. 20th Feb, Friday, 11:55, NOR is tendered. On 20th Feb, at 1 o'clock, the load-in is supposed to commence. So, I mean, if you see, now I'll just go to the question. So, if you ask me, I mean, you can say that the lay time is supposed to start because then NOR was tendered before 12 o'clock and it was supposed to start at 1400. Why did we start at 1300? Because if you see this clause, upon commencement of loading, whichever occurs first. So the loading starts at 1 o'clock here. Okay, that is why our loading starts and the NOR lay time starts counting. On 20th, from 2 o'clock to 6 o'clock, we have to count the lay time, which is 4, which is in total, there was 4 hours to be used, which was used, sorry. On 21st, on Saturday, now there is the loading stops at 6 o'clock and next day it starts at 8 o'clock in the morning. From 8 to 10, if you see, from 8 to 10, we have 2 hours, but still we have written 1 hour because we are supposed to take half lay time. And if you see, time after Friday, so we are after Friday till 7 o'clock in the morning, the lay time will count half unless used. That is why we are supposed to take any lay time carried between these time frame, which will become half. So 21st Saturday, from 10 to 11:20, there was rain. On 21st Saturday itself, we had from 11:20 to 12, it resumed. So out of which, if you see 40 minutes again, we have to take half. That is why it's 20 minutes here. On 21st Feb, Saturday, from 1300 hours till 1800 hours, it's roughly around 5 hours. And we have to take it again, the half one. So it becomes 12 and a half. On 22nd, now let's come on 22nd, which is Sunday. The loading on Sunday, the loading starts at 10 o'clock till 11:30, in which the crane, there's a crane breakdown from 1:30 to 15:45. Here we are from 10 to 12, 1. And then we have 1 hour break, 12 to 1 o'clock. Why? Because if you see, the stevedores are working from timings from morning 7 to 12. The sixth shift is from 1 to 6 o'clock. And the third shift starts from 7 to 11:30. That's why we've taken 1300 hours. From 1330, it starts 15 minutes because even though it's half an hour, we have to make it half. From 1330 till 1545, there's a crane breakdown. Let's go ahead. 22nd February, Sunday, from 3:45 till 6 o'clock, lay time used is 1 hour, 8 minutes. Again, there is 1 hour gap because the third shift starts from 7 o'clock. It goes till 11:30. That makes it twice of this time. That is why we have written half, which is 2 hours 15 minutes. Now Monday, everything resumes as normal. So if you see, the first shift of stevedores start from morning 7 to 12 o'clock. That's why we have taken 5 hours. The second shift starts from 1 to 6, which is again 5 hours. The third shift starts as from 7 to 11:30, which is 4 and a half hours. So for the whole day, it went fine. On 23rd, on Tuesday, if you see, there is a halt in the morning because of rain from morning 3:30 to 8 o'clock. We could have started from morning 7 as per the shift, but since there is a halt, we will start from 8 o'clock. From 8 to 12, again, 4 hours to be counted. On 23rd, again, the second shift, which is 1 to 6 o'clock, which is 5 hours. On 23rd, then third shift is from evening 7 o'clock to 11:30 at night, which is 4 hours 30 minutes. On 24th, morning 7, the first shift again from 7 to 12. On 24th, it's 1 to 5:35 because that is the time where loading finishes. That's why it's 4:35. After that, loading is complete, as I said. At 18:625, documents on board. 24th, 6:50, vessel is sailed. We have finished our lay time. Now we need to sum up what the whole lay time we have consumed in the problem. The total lay time used is 2 days, 3 hours, 3 minutes. If you total all this, how do we come to know the lay time allowed? In order to calculate lay time allowed, we know the total cargo quantity carried, which was 82,594.37 metric ton. And the total loading rate, which was given in the question, is 30,000 metric ton. Yeah. If you divide 82,594.37 by 30,000, you get 2 days, 18 hours, 5 minutes. So that is the lay time allowed. In this situation, the total time consumed is lesser than the lay time allowed. So there is a reward, there is a dispatch. And how much is the dispatch is? 2 hours 18.05 minus this, it comes out to be 15 hours 02 minutes. So this is a dispatch. Now how much is the dispatch we need to calculate? Since the dispatch is 8625 per day. Now the demurrage rate which was given to us in the question was 17,250 per day pro rata, which was DHT. That means that if it's a dispatch, you need to divide this figure 17,250 by 2, which will give you 8,625 per day. And if you multiply this amount with 15 hours, 2 minutes, you get your dispatch as $5,402. That's how we calculate this question. And there are many questions for you guys. I mean, I've already kept a lot of material for you, which I won't be covering. Let's go to the abbreviation part. So I have compiled a list of abbreviations which are normally used in lay time calculation, which will help you to understand to solve these questions. COP is custom of port. Vessel to load and discharge as the customary in the particular port. CRR is current rate loading. CRD is current rate discharging. EIU. If you see this word called as EIU, is even if used. If the cargo is loaded or discharged during these days, lay time not to count. FAC is fast as can. Loading and or discharging to take place as fast as possible. FAS, free alongside. FD is free discharge. No discharge expenses be charged to owners. FHEX, UU. Friday and holiday excluded unless used. That means Friday and holidays do not count in lay time unless used. Okay. Friday holiday excluded even if used. Friday and holiday excluded even if used, as I said. And Friday and holidays do not count in lay time even if. First one is Fridays and holiday included. Fridays and holidays count in lay time as normal days. FIO, FIOS, FIOT, FIOST. So these are the terms which I did speak about in lecture one, where we were trying to understand different costs. And in this, all these costs are borne by the charterer. These are cargo handling costs. So if these terms are used in a charter party, owners are no cost to owners. Owners are not supposed to pay anything for the cargo handling. SHEXUU. Sunday and holiday is excluded unless used. Sundays or holidays do not count in lay time unless used. Similarly, we have Sunday holiday excluded even if used. What does this mean? Sunday and holidays do not count in lay time even if loading and discharging operation takes place. FOB is free on board. SH Inc. is Sunday holidays included. Sunday and holidays count in lay time as normal days. VIB on, whether in berth or not. Lay time to commence counting whether the vessel is in berth or not. VWD is working days, normal working days. WT is working time saved. Lay time saved, or for which owners will have to pay dispatch to the charterers. WWD is weather working days. Days that work can be performed subject to the weather condition. VIP on, whether in port or not. Lay time to commence counting whether the vessel is in port or not. UU is unless used. If the cargo loaded or discharged during these days, lay time to count as normal days. With this, guys, we finish off our lecture. I've already provided a link for you. If you want to know more of these terms, abbreviations, you can always go to the link and you can come to know. Thank you. Question of the day. I would like you guys to try out the dry cargo lay time questions by yourself and let me know if you have any issues with it in the comment section below. Hit the like button if you like the video, guys. And remember, one of the most important tips and feedback come from you guys. So feel free to connect me on LinkedIn. So thanks for checking out the video. Subscribe if you haven't already. In the next lecture, we are going to see the voyage estimate question. So until next time, ShipScope is bringing you the best platform to learn about the commercial shipping subjects. Keep on crushing it and we will talk soon.